Hello, it's Nick, and today I want to show you four popular UI kits for Figma. UI kit is a compilation of reusable UI components, styles, and other assets that can help you design your product. And Material UI kit is first one on our list. This kit provides a great introduction to the material design system by Google, and Google actively updates this kit, so new things appear all the time. The kit itself includes basic things like styles and components, and please note that the icons are not included in this kit, and you can download them as a separate Figma file. Let's review components. The components include all essential UI components that we can find in web apps and mobile apps, such as checkbox, chips, data pickers, buttons, carousels, lists, menus, navigation bars, etc. And the great thing that all components here are available in two versions, light and dark mode. And we can easily see how to use them. So for example, I want to check the buttons. Let's copy it here. And as you can see, the button itself has variants. So right now it's felt variant, but we can change it to outline and it appears as outline button. So the variables are ready to use, so no need to modify anything. All set for you. And regarding the styles, Material Design UI kit offers a type scale that you can use with a roboto font, color guidance. As you probably guess, it uses the Material Design system colors. So most of them work well for the light and dark tone. And the things like elevation and additional elements also included here. So elevation is the Z index that we can vary to make the element closer or distant, more distant from the ground. And layout breakpoints, which are very useful when you design different kinds of apps or websites. It includes breakpoints for the large viewport, medium, and small, and even an extra small one. So this will help you to guide your design process. Material Design Kit has a few downsides, and a major downside that I found is that it doesn't include the keyboard. Mobile keyboard is simply doesn't listed here among the components. Full list of the components actually available here. Another downside is that it doesn't feature examples of the screens that use these components. So we can have the list of the components, but we don't have an examples of how we can use them in actual design. iOS 17 and iPadOS 17 is design library and templates created by Apple. This is official UI kit created by Apple for Figma, and it features essential components and elements. But before we will use this kit, it's important to do one thing. It's important to install the latest version of San Francisco Symbols. But after that, we have access to massive collections of UI elements that Apple uses in its products. So as you can see here, the collection of components includes everything that we need to design a general app. For example, we can check what the list of the components controls features. So each control actually has variants, so we can play with mode, size, style, state, and material. And unlike the Material UI kit, Apple also included one important thing, which is the keyboard. And as you can see, each component is available in both in light and dark theme. And another great benefit of using this UI kit is that it also includes some small things like bezels, which are extremely valuable when you design a prototype. And it's also for the features how we can use actual component in design. For example, here you can see how we can use alerts. And we can just double click for our UI element and see how we can position it in layout. This is a really valuable feature that saves a lot of time. And regarding the styles, this UI kit includes colors, materials, such as tones, and textiles. And the type scale system that Apple features, it includes more variations. So it features text styles, dynamic type table, and even accessibility sizes. And it also features safe area, which is really valuable when you design for iPad or iOS. Your content won't be trimmed because you will always design for the safe area. And another interesting thing, the changelog, so you can read the changelog to understand what was added and what was removed for the UI kit. And design is next on our list, and this is a massive UI kit, even in comparison to the Material Design and Apple iOS and iPad kits. It includes a lot of things, and the great thing that the kit provides a great overview for what is included, so the visual overview, so you don't need to read much text, you can see what you will get. And this is really interesting approach to informing the designer what will included. Another great thing about this kit that it also features some pre-designed pages, and some of them are really common, such as account login screen. So we can use this login screen without too much changes if we want to design something really, really quick. But otherwise, it also features some more complex screens, such as analytics screen, which is really uncommon because this is a fairly complex screen. Talking about the components, it includes a lot of things. So for example, here you can see the component button, and it includes principles, design principles that is used for designing this component, how we can use it, and actual states for each component. All is available on the same page, and which is extremely valuable, I think. It also features a great collection of style and elements, such as icons. It's an excellent collection of icons that we can use for different scenarios. And other things such as navigation. So basically you can dive into and learn about this UI kit. You will spend some time, but I highly recommend you to check in this out. Regarding the usage of this kit, I would say that it's mostly designed for the web apps. It's less applicable to the mobile apps, but still you can design a universal thing like a web app that will work best for the desktop and on mobile too. Microsoft Fluent 2 is the last UI kit on our list, but it's a great kit, and it's available in two versions. This one is a version for the web, but Microsoft also releases the version for the mobiles. And the kit features a really clean approach for informing the users what's included, so we can read the docs on how to get started, how the kit can be used. And for each component, it follows the same approach that we saw for the Ant. So we can see, for example, for the accordion, how accordion uses, example in the UI design, how it will look like and how it will work, and the component that we can use. For example, here we'll see the component for the accordion, and it also features variables, so we can expand it. And the list of the components is relatively big, so we can play with it and find the components that will work for our particular scenario. And the last thing that I want to say is that, similar to the Apple, the changelog right inside the UI kit, so you can read what was changed recently and what was introduced in the UI kit. So this is it. These were four UI kits that I was talking about today. Thank you.